Welcome to this part 5 session on data encryption standard, the DES. In this session, we will understand what is triple DES and how it improves on the single DES. We provide an Excel template and allow you to experiment and understand. We assume that you have already viewed our earlier 4 parts, else you will feel discontinuity in following this tutorial. Please download the Excel workbook from the address given below. There are no macros in that Excel workbook. We have used the regular formulae and functions only. In the triple DES algorithm workbook, you will find 11 sheets. The summary sheet is for data entry and for checking the results. Lookup sheet contains substitution tables. Each key sheet gives the derivation of 16 subkeys from the main key. The remaining are encryption and decryption worksheets relating to each key. DES algorithm might appear to be a complicated encryption method, but it could be cracked because the same key is used for encryption and decryption, and its block size is just 64 bits. Hackers can launch a brute force attack against the text by simply trying as many keys as possible. Superfast computers have been able to cycle through the entire 56-bit DES key and crack it within 56 hours. Given its limitation, DES has not kept up with the advances in technology. Triple DES is an improved version of DES. Simply stated, triple DES is DES repeated 3 times by running the algorithm in succession with 3 different keys. The resulting key is 56 by 3, 168 bits. We know DES involves 16 rounds per operation. Triple DES therefore uses 3 by 16, 48 rounds per operation. Both DES and triple DES are symmetric block ciphers, and the text blocks that they operate on continue to remain the same 64 bits. Triple DES is being discussed with differing alternate patterns. These are like 3 key option, 168 bit key, 2 key option, 112 bit key, with the encryption, 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 slash decryption, 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 or encryption, decryption, encryption, followed with decryption, encryption, decryption, and so on. Let us begin with 3 key method. In it, the text is encrypted 3 times in succession. It is first encrypted with key 1, then that text is encrypted using key 2, and finally key 3 encrypts the last message text. As we know, using more keys is always cumbersome, but it is also more secure. For this option, we will use 168 bits underscore triple E underscore triple DES or XLSX. Enter your plain text in C2 to R2 of summary sheet and your choice of 3 keys in C3 to R5. All values to be entered in hexadecimal. Now the keys part. Cell range B4 to Q4 in each of the key sheet refers to the respective key value in the summary sheet. ENC star means the respective encryption. DCR star means the respective decryption. As we are aware that the decryption takes the reverse path of encryption, the full path now is encryption 1, encryption 2, encryption 3, followed by decryption 3, decryption 2, decryption 1. Note, nodes 1 and 6 form a single DES, and so do nodes 2 and 5 and 3 and 4. So in effect, this triple DES is a combination of 3 single DES. Encryption part. Cell range B6 to Q6 in ENC 1, which is the starting point of encryption,
refers to the plain text in the summary sheet. Cell range B141 to Q141 in ENC3 gives us the final encrypted ciphertext. This is carried to cells U3 to AJ3 of the summary sheet. Decryption part. Cell range B6 to Q6 in DCR3, which is the starting point of decryption, refers to the ciphertext in the summary sheet. Finally, cell range B141 to Q141 in DCR1 gives us the decrypted plain text. This is carried to the cell range U4 to AJ4 of the summary sheet. This concludes the 3-key chain 168-bit EEE DDD double test. There is also a 2-key option provided in triple test that runs through a method called encrypt decrypt encrypt EDE. The encryption is applied to the text using key 1. This encrypted text is decrypted using key 2. Lastly, the decrypted text from step 2 is encrypted again using key 1. We will use 112 bits_EDE_SSX for this option. Enter your plain text in C2 to R2 of summary sheet and your choice of two keys in C3 to R4. Keys part. Cell range B4 to Q4 in key 1 and key 2 sheets refer to the respective key values in the summary sheet. Key 3 copies key 1 again because our pattern is 1-2-1. The decryption takes the reverse path of the encryption, so the full path is encryption 1, decryption 2, encryption 1, followed by decryption 1, encryption 2, and decryption 1. Note, this again is a combination of 3 single desks, 1 and 6, 2 and 5, 3 and 4. In our implementation, encryption 1 and decryption 1 appearing for a second time in 3 and 4 node is being called encryption 3 and decryption 3. Encryption part. Cell range B6 to Q6 in encryption 1, which is the starting point of encryption, refers to plain text in the summary sheet. Cell range B141 to Q141 in encryption 3 gives us the encrypted ciphertext. This is carried to cell range U3 to AJ3 of the summary sheet. Now the decryption part. Cell range B6 to Q6 in DCR3, which is the starting point of decryption, refers to the ciphertext in the summary sheet. Finally, cell range B141 to Q141 in DCR1 give us the decrypted plain text. This is carried to U4 to AJ4 of the summary sheet. This concludes the 2-key chained 112-bit EDE followed by DED triple S. We do not propose to discuss the merits of each pattern separately, but arm you with a third Excel template, TripleTestAlgorithm.xlsx. You may try entering various desk patterns as you desire and understand yourselves. We will come to this shortly. Each combination of key, text and algorithm is presented as a separate package. Please note, encryption is a standalone package and so is decryption. In our workbook, you have 6 packages, but all the packages refer to the same lookup and permutation tables. For example, ENC1 is a standalone encryption unit and it is a combination of encryption algorithm, key 1 and message. The 16 required subkeys are supplied by key 1, though there is a coupling between the operation and its key, but there is no coupling between one operation and the other.
Have you noticed in the diagrams that there is an IP inversion at the end of each operation and an IP permutation at the beginning? These two put together have the effect of leaving the ciphertext unchanged. One annuls the other. Check AH138 to AW138 of the conversion sheet and AH9 to AW9 of the decryption sheet in our earlier desalgorithm.xlsx. You will find both of them to be the same. The fact that we have done an IP inversion in row 139 of encryption and an IP permutation of row 8 of decryption do not matter really. Right? Then why are they there? We can understand their necessity if encryption part is treated as a producer and the decryption part as consumer. The producer will encrypt and send the cipher to the consumer for decryption. But in the triple disk process, we are placing these operations next to each other, where the first operation would either be an encryption or be a decryption, is the producer, and the immediately next operation is the consumer, both happening at the same place. So aren't we wasting our efforts by adding one inversion at the end and annulling it immediately by doing a permutation at the beginning of the other? Yes, we are. But we have allowed the luxury of these wasted system efforts because it helps us in avoiding coupling between operational patterns. It also makes things easy for you to try out various alternate linkings, which we will see shortly.
But don't ignore the right and left shifting of 32 bits that happens at the end of every encryption or decryption before we do the IP inversion. Refer to rows 27, 28 or 44, 45 of the summary sheet where we have shown all the keys. This shifting of bits will be very apparent.
Say, if you wanted to create a pattern of key 1 encryption, key 2 decryption and key 3 encryption, or key 1 encryption, key 2 encryption, key 3 encryption, or even key 1 encryption, key 2 decryption, key 1 encryption, the independence of each sheet as a standalone object would be very helpful.
We'll use TripleDiskAlgorithm.xlsx for this option. Enter plain text in C2 to R2 in hexadecimal format in the summary sheet. If you wish to work with 168-bit keys, select 3 keys of your choice and enter them in C3 to R5 in the same sheet. Enter the triple disk pattern of your choice in cells AS3 to AU3. This cell range is highlighted in green. A positive value entered here means encryption and a negative value denotes decryption. For example, if you enter 2, then it means encryption 2, while minus 2 means it is decryption 2, and so on. If you wish to work with only 2 keys, that is 112-bit keys, that you can map appropriately. For a 2-key EDE pattern, the numbers would be shown as 1, minus 2, 1. In this workbook, though you are entering the encryption pattern only, the decryption part is identified and internally generated. You will find the sheet values like the keys, the plain text and the ciphertext keep changing between the sheets as per the triple disk pattern of your choice. This might cause some confusion amongst viewers, and that is the reason why we have demonstrated the two earlier hard linked Excel books. You are welcome to experiment with various triple disk patterns of your choice and appreciate the security provided by triple disk. Decrypting your own ciphertext and testing the bit changes using avalanche effect are also built in our Excel workbooks. The way to use them has already been outlined in part 3 of our tutorial. We hope that you get a complete handle on triple disk algorithms try all the available alternate patterns. Bye.